Let me first preface by saying, although I feel like I know quite a lot about Ken, and although I main Ken in Street Fighter 4, Ken is a lot different of a character than I was expecting, having looked at all his attacks versus like seeing tournament play for him. That's not that true, but there was a lot of stuff I didn't really theorize as being helpful or possible that I then saw people doing. So just take this whole video with a grain of salt. Ken, 1,000 health, 1,000 stun. Movement's pretty good. He does have a way to alter his jump arc. It's one of the best ones in the game, actually, in the form of his Area X Tatsu. He can also alter his jump arc with his normal Tatsu, but that's usually not useful because it doesn't hit on the back like it did in Street Fighter 4. And I think it's not as good at coward coptering as Ryu's is because it has more of a downward momentum to it. But coward coptering, even with Ryu, is not that good in this game. But with Ken, it's worse because you've got the ground recovery and it doesn't actually like make him go that high in the air. But he does have a really quick dash. He also has a pretty good back dash in terms of distance. And he can alter his jump arc. So in terms of movement, he's pretty good. His V skill is also very movement oriented, which makes it even that much better. I don't know what to say about a Star Ranger, if there's anything. I should just not even bring up Throw Range anytime I'm talking about this sort of stuff. That's pretty much it in terms of like his general movement. Normals. Let's see here. Stand Light Punch is +4, and Ken is one of two characters in the game with a 4-frame medium normal, I think. I think? And Fung might have one, actually. But Ken can link into back strong, which is 4 frames from his stand jab. So he has a link out of lights into mediums, but it only works point blank, so you can't do like strings into it. That being said, it actually converts to pretty good damage. So if you're in a situation where you need a 4-frame punish, Ken is one of the best characters in the game in terms of his damage output there. Something like that. Let's see here. Anyway, if you want a combo from basically between his lights, they're all pretty much very similar. His low short is +3, and he doesn't have a 3-frame normal, so you've got a chain out of it. And I think it chains into stand jab and crouch jab, but not stand short. So if you want a combo out of a low, I think your best option, what I usually see people do, is just straight to hard uppercut. You can also go into, I think, light and maybe medium Tatsu, but these don't get the startup hits of the Tatsu, so they're not that strong. Okay, only light. If you use stand short as your link option, I think you can, yeah, get the it's only from stand jab though. Stand jab, stand short gives you the startup hit of the Tatsu, which gives you extra damage. Because you have some combos that aren't normally available there. But if you're gonna do that, the only reason you would ever use that is a really fast punish, I think. I mean, you could use this as a standalone confirm. And that would give you a greater damage potential than it would be a better tick than that, while giving you greater damage potential than this, but it's not off a low, so it's not as helpful as it sounds. It's probably just good for like after a cross-up or something. And actually, I'm not sure that you can really even do much with that Tatsu. I guess you'd have to go medium Tatsu into EX DP, which is still pretty good. I was trying to get the hard DP link, but I'm not sure if that works there. Now, let me turn on my damage and whatnot before I forget. Straight into after first attack. It's a nice setting to have. Anyway, crouch jab combos into stand jab. Stand jab combos into stand short. Low short combos into low jab or stand jab. Basically, your two low confirms that I would say are really important, or not low confirms, light confirms, are jab back strong, which leads to a lot of damage, and crouch short any jab, which leads to an uppercut. That one's important because it's like your best low confirm. Best is a strong word. I've seen Momochi get crouch medium kick into super like it's a confirm. I don't know if you can actually hit confirm that, but he sure makes it look like you can. I don't really have that much to say about lights besides that. There are a couple situations where you have to go through lights just purely because you need attack that's really, really fast. Like if you get a... Oh. Dude, did I fuck that up? Ryu's Tatsu doesn't hit in the back, but Ken still does. God damn it, fuck. That's one of the first things I opened with. And I remembered that, like, it was useful for his combos out of cross-up Tatsu. Anyway, he actually does have a couple 3-frame attacks, he just doesn't have a 3-frame normal. But off very specific Tatsus, I think it can help to go through a light normal. I think actually back strong is your best hope. But don't correct me on that shit, dude, fuck. I'll talk about cross-up Tatsu later on. I'm pretty sure you can get a back strong out of that. You definitely can a V-trigger. There it is. It's like super precise. Yeah, maybe not using because you have a 4-frame normal, you probably don't need to go through lights at any point. You cannot just go straight into back strong in a situation like that. Let's see here. Stand medium punch 7 frames. This button is pretty good to go into as like a kind of frame trap option, just purely because it's got a very particular speed to it. Most of Ken's attacks are kind of slow. A 7-frame normal is unfortunately one of his faster ones. He's got a 5-frame crouch medium punch and a 6-frame crouch hard punch, and a 6-frame crouch medium kick. But that's like everything between. There's nothing else. There's nothing else between like 4 and 7. And none of those attacks really represent like a standing. None of them are that good for frame trapping. Ken's got really unusual frame trap options. They're kind of good, but they're really unusual. How do I crouch? Stand medium punch, despite its hitbox and despite what you may be used to with other Street Fighter games, does hit crouching opponents. You can't link into it from anything except like jump and attacks. You might be able to link into it from certain counter hit stuff, and it does cancel. So if you're doing like something like that, which is like a string I see a little bit, or something like that, you can cancel it. That being said, because it doesn't actually combo from a lot of stuff, it's not very useful to cancel it most of the time. Maybe like a DX Fireball, something like that, if you're like fishing for hits. But there's not a lot of stuff that Ken can really cancel into safely because his uppercut's really unsafe, his fireball is kind of unsafe up close, and his Tatsu is really unsafe. He has no other special moves. God, Ken. Ken is such a weird character. Anyway, stand medium punch is good as a poke. You can use it to empty cancel a little bit, I guess. You could like empty cancel it into stand medium punch. I mean, into medium Tatsu. Which would probably be alright, except it's a Tatsu, so it wouldn't hit a crouching opponent, so you'd hope that they didn't walk in and then crouch somehow. But that's usually not an issue for empty cancels. You could also empty cancel its uppercut, I guess, but I don't know if that'll always reach. You'd probably rather go into EX uppercut. You need something that'll hit someone. If you're going to do empty cancel, you need something that'll hit someone, even if you're hitting the extended limb, and I don't think that'll usually happen with anything outside of, like, medium Tatsu. Or rather, not the. You need something that you can hit the extended limb, and then you can still hit their body. I'm not even sure if medium Tatsu is going to be that good for that, so I don't think Ken's empty cancels outside of his super are that useful. Or at least not off of that normal. I don't have that much to say about stand medium punch. Most Kens don't hit it that much. Crouch medium punch is an entirely different story. It comes out pretty fast, again, 5 frames, so you can do it kind of quickly. It comes it, like it from a certain range, from around here. It's like it's got pretty good chance to interrupt the opponent's actions just purely because it's so fast, and it is a medium normal, so it's good. It's fairly good at interrupting compared to lights. It interacts favorably with a lot of other hitboxes, basically. It'll hit the startup frames of hard normals a lot of the time, and it will trade or win against other medium normals depending on relative timings. That was a pretty good little poke. And it's +1 on block, which means it's really good for his pressure. It's well, hold on, what's his other? I think he's got a plus. Yeah, he's stand jab is +2, and crouch jab is +2. So those are your absolute best in terms of like tick options. You'd rather do probably stand jab most of the time because it's the most frame advantage on hit, and then you can also follow it with a throw really easily. But you can also do low strong confirms more easily because it's got more hit stop because it's a medium normal. So you can more easily react to its success, and it's still like pretty good on block. Like if the opponent blocks it, they're -1, and you have like fast attacks. You could do like into stand short or something like that, and it will interrupt pretty much anything they do. And if they're teching late or if they're not teching at all, you could maybe walk in for a throw, or you could like do a slower normal like that. Stuff like that. More importantly, it's the start of a lot of his combos, or rather his max damage combos. It's plus 4 on hit, and he does have a 4 frame normal. So, in terms of like a link to add damage, that's pretty much his go-to if you do low strong back strong, and that leads back strong leads to his tower combo, and his tower combo leads to some of his highest grounded damage. That would be like a very bread and butter combo for Ken. And that looks like it's really range dependent, and it is. You have to be really close in order for that link to work. Pretty much point blank. That's a really important thing that Ken has to consider. But you can still do it after like a jump in or something like that. And the cool thing about that combo is if that link is close enough to work, then the Tatsu is close enough to work. Because the thing about the tower combo is the Tatsu can fall out depending on the range. I'm gonna have to like artificially create that scenario. It's really hard to actually set up, but it's like I've seen it happen a few times in match. I'm gonna spend an hour trying to make it whiff. Whatever. It's working pretty well now. You can also end that tower combo in uppercut, which never has the issue of falling out, but leads to less damage. I just dropped a hit, but you can get all three. And all three hits do the same damage as all the hits of Hard Tatsu. I think it's just corner carry and dizzy that are the differences. Let's actually figure that out right now. That's 216, 312 versus 216, 272. Yeah. Tatsu has better corner carry and better stun, but I don't know if the Oki's better. Sometimes I hear Ken's like they like to end with the uppercut because they like the Oki, but then I hear a bunch of Ken say it doesn't matter at all, or that Tatsu's Oki is actually better, stuff like that. I thought Tatsu's Oki was better. I thought you could, like, if the opponent quick stood, you could do, like, a. What was it? Is it back medium kick? Something like that. It's been, like, maybe. That looks too slow. I might have just done it late, though. Anyway, little sidetracked. Low strong leads to his really strong combos on hit. It also. If you're just doing this mindlessly, it's a little bit, it only works really, really close. And back strong on block is like -2, I think, so, you don't always want to go into back strong. You can do a link into stand short instead, which works at, I think, more ranges. And, only leads to a bit less damage. Well, that's not true, it leads to quite a bit less damage. But, you can get combos like that. I see that a lot. That's a confirm I see from Ken players all the time. They do that into uppercut or that into Tatsu or something like that. Quite common. That's like one of Ken's very few confirms that doesn't involve his run in some way. Or tart combos. That's like his only confirm that doesn't involve his run or his tart combos. Let's see here. Stand medium kick. This button's pretty interesting. It's got a really high hitbox. I think it still hits crouching opponents. Not at a range. Or maybe I'm just outside the range of the attack. One, two. Okay. Yeah, it looks like it just hits crouching opponents pretty easily. And it does force stand, which means that if you hit a crouching opponent with it, you can then hit them with the other half of the tart combo. Which I think does whiff on crouching opponents. Yeah. So the problem with that tart combo, I mean, it's a good tart combo. It's the other one he has. It's pretty much it's like the alternative to back strong. Back strong is a lot faster though, so it's you see it a lot more. I guess I'll talk about the tower combo now because it's fully entailed into the stand medium kick. The stand medium kick has a really good hitbox in terms of like the angle in which it hits, which makes it really useful for some scenarios that Ken can create like that. It's kind of difficult to get any of his normals besides stand medium kick to hit really reliably there, and a stand medium kick does cancel into his V skill, so you can go for stuff like that and get sneaky real cross unders or fake cross unders, and give the opponent problems. Kind of difficult to get a fake cross under like that though. But if you do it perfectly, it can be really difficult to react to. I think it requires a late button press. But What did my mom say about Brexit? I don't know if I can get a fake cross under. I don't know the timing. I've done it before, but I don't want to spend like a really long time trying to find it. Anyway, the point is you can get a couple mix-ups like that by canceling into V-skill or V-trigger. More commonly, you'll just cross the opponent up, which can catch a lot of people unsuspecting if they're not used to fighting Kens. But it's a really good little juggle anyway. Like, as a reset, you can get a reset going, and the only other things you can juggle into are, like... Well, he's got a couple of other... I think he can link it to, like, a stronger normal, but if you're going with grid damage, you just end with an uppercut or something like that. I missed the timing. I think you can get three hits there. Let's see. Anyway, Stand Medium Kick is pretty much just used for its nice little hitbox there. It does whiff cancel into his hard kick, which is really more of a bad thing than a good thing, because it means you can't use it for empty canceling pretty much at all. I think if you're really, really good, that you can probably do... I mean, you don't even have to be that good. I'm pretty sure it's possible that you can do Stand Medium Kick, react to success or failure, and then hit Stand Hard Kick. I'm pretty sure... It feels easier than doing it from Back Medium Punch, Hard Punch. I'm not 100% sure that you can confirm either of them inherently, but having tried a bunch for both of them, the kick one feels easier. So, like, if you, like, did medium kick and you saw it was blocked, you wouldn't hit hard kick. And if you did medium kick and you saw it hit, you would hit hard kick. There's, like, a window where it seems like you can react and then only do the second one on success. And you have the same follow-ups here, but I think it's much more common here for Tatsu to whiff, because it works from much further away than his other tower combo. So if you're using it from the absolute max ranges, you're going to be able to... I keep on canceling really early. You're not going to be able to land that. Max range still combos with uppercut, I'm pretty sure. So uppercut's kind of the preferred one here, but if you're up close, they both work. I think? I guess not. I thought they did. That might have been a beta thing, and I might be talking with super outdated shit. Or that might have just never worked, and I forgot. And an uppercut. People always end an uppercut after this one, and I can see why. This one does work from a lot farther away, so if you're in a situation where you're doing, like, a max range jump in, your back medium punch combos aren't going to work. But from a range like this, you can still get your medium kick, hard kick, tower combo. So that's still important from, like, if you're trying to, like, attack from a very far range, if you're jumping from over a fireball from something like here. There are little situations where it's the preferred tower combo. That being said, I don't know all of them. It does do, I think, a little bit more damage than this other one. 114 versus 104. That being said, the fact that you can link to the other one annuls that damage difference. But 153 with an additional 10% scaling. Still stronger most of the time. Let's actually just get a hard damage comparison. Even as few hits as these should be fairly telling. 226. 251, yeah. I think Ken is pretty strong. I didn't think he was strong when I was initially looking at him, but I thought he had a lot of potential, so I like wouldn't have been surprised if he turned into a really good character, and then he kind of did, so... I remember a lot of people were saying that he was really weak, and Ryu as well, and I thought that was just ridiculous. But now people are... It's just because they were nerfed a lot between the beta and now. Ryu and Ken were, like, the best characters in the beta. And now they're, like... They were nerfed, and now they're still probably two of the strongest in the game. That's really all I have to say about his... Oh yeah, that tower combo is pretty unsafe on block, especially because they can crouch the second hit, so don't just do it willy-nilly, you need to confirm it. And you can't really link into Stand Medium Kick from anything except jump in, so you can't easily confirm it. You need to have it inherently confirm itself, or you need to go for it in situations where it's guaranteed. In practice, I don't use it that much, but I see Kens use it in specific scenarios, so it's not bad by any means. Stand Medium Kick by itself is minus two. Wow, I wonder if that means you can, like, link out of it into light uppercut on counter hit. Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. You'd probably never see that. Yeah. Doesn't work really well at the ranges where you might be going for it. It does move him in a little bit, too, so you could probably use it as a... I mean, using it as a throw reset is a bit strong because it's minus two. They might be using it to reset you, if you know what I mean. Crouch medium kick. This move is a little bit like his Street Fighter 4 version of this move, except it's shittier in every way. It's still really good because you can still, like, kind of poke with it. It's not as good a poke as it was in previous games. It doesn't go as far, and it loses to more attacks. They're more kind of like low crush kind of pokes in this game. Like, buttons that'll, like, do kind of comfortably against most lows. Not actual low crushes that are like immune to lows or anything like that, but they're just more buttons that counterproc lows in my experience. But you can empty it. This cancels as well, and it goes pretty far compared to most of his cancels. It doesn't go quite as far as Stand Strong, but it does. You can empty cancel into shit like EX Tatsu or stuff like that. So you can get like you can catch people trying to walk into attacks, and it does combo to EX Tatsu from like all ranges. Still have counter hit on, don't I? You can also go into like medium or light Tatsu, but it's too slow for heavy. I think the only things you can link into heavy Tatsu from are his target combos and fierce and I think low strong. And that just comboed. That combo too, stand strong. Hard Tatsu is kind of slow and doesn't work from a lot of scenarios. Karin 6 medium kick low crushes her own? Oh, towards medium kick. Yeah, that's an actual low crush. Her overhead. Let's see here. Crouch medium kick, it's you can't really link into it like you could in previous games. 6 frames. You can link into it on counter hit from jab, which is nearly useless. Because you can link into much better things on counter hit from jab. It's mostly just used as a ranged cancel, and it's not even that useless a ranged cancel in this game. Again, I've seen Momochi do this thing where he like does it. And then he sees whether it hits or is blocked, and then supers. But I don't know if that's like. It does have kind of a late cancel window, but I can't even imagine actually confirming into a super off of that. You need like inhuman reactions. Actually, that felt kind of loose. That might be a lot more practical than I'm giving it credit for. It looks like you maybe actually could react there. Yeah, that's a really late cancel. Fun fact, Ken's crouch medium kick has an extremely delayed cancel window. I don't have that much to say about crouch medium kick. It's like hard to make it work as a low poke the way you could in Street Fighter 4, and I don't think it's useless, but you can't use it in the way that I'm used to using Ken's crouch medium kick in other games. So it is kind of useful because it's a low, but there isn't anything you can link out of it, and if you cancel it, then everything you can cancel into is unsafe. So except EX Fireball. So I don't really like it's kind of hard to use it outside of a standalone move like a poke or a combo where it's usually outclassed. Stand Hard Punch is kind of an interesting move. It's the normal that Ken has with the longest hit stun, which is really useful for a lot of things. Namely, if you cancel it to V skill, it's +3 on hit, which means that if you do Stand Hard Punch, you can't link any normals after it or anything like that, but if you do Stand Hard Punch cancel to V skill, you can actually link a Light Tatsu or a Light Uppercut. Light Tatsu is much more common because it leads to higher damage. But this is a proof of concept, there you go. Those are Ken's 2 3-frame attacks. Light Tatsu, you can get a hard uppercut in most instances. You can't do it if you hit like a real range, but this combo removes range from the equation pretty much, even a max range stand hard punch. We'll give you a point blank Light Tatsu. So that leads to pretty good damage. Unfortunately, hold on, let me actually calculate that. It's 8 frames between the on block and the on hit. That's +5 on hit. Well, it leaves you at a range where you can't really do anything, I think. Okay, you can do that. I'm gonna be honest, I didn't know that worked. Neat. I've never seen a Ken do that. Anyway, it's +3, so it goes to -5 if they block it. So, it's not safe to just willy-nilly stand fierce cancel into run. So it's more something you see Kens do, like after like far range jump-ins or stuff like that. Very common. But you can also link into medium Tatsu rather than using V skill at all, and medium Tatsu gives much higher damage potential if you get the startup hit. I did not get the startup hit there. So that would have been a situation where Stand Fierce into Run would have been better. But like very, very far confirms are like the only situation where I really no, I see that a lot. I just see it fishing for crush counters. People only go for the run when they get the crush counter. That being said, here we go. Stand Fierce is a crush counter normal. The hit stun is almost identical on crush counter as it is on hit. You only get like 2 additional frames of recoil compared to what it normally is. You can link it to a few things. You link it to Stand Strong. Yeah. So that's a 7-frame normal, and it doesn't work. Unless it does, and I'm just mistiming it. And his 6-frame crouch medium kick works. So this is going from plus 5 to, like, plus 6. Am I right? Am I wrong? It could just be that the same medium punch is hitting late or something. That one additional frame means quite a lot, though. You can react to the crush counter with a V skill if you're really looking for it. And if you see it and you get the V skill, you can do a run and then a back medium punch. And that back medium punch link, of course, leads to a lot of damage. That's like his max damage, like meterless combo from the ground. And that's also your crush counter punish. Like if you block a DP from Ryu, this is his crush counter that doesn't launch, which makes it ideal for going for like big punish combos. Stay in fierce, run into back strong. It's a pretty weird combo, but it's pretty good. Very good after blocking an uppercut. Hurts quite a lot. It's really good to fish for crush counters from Ken too, because this is a pretty fast attack that's not very bad to just throw out. And Ken has like a big V bar that takes a long time to build. So using lots of stand fierce is good. Even outside counter hit, you can link into his V skill hit too, I think. But that's almost useless. Let's see. I feel like there's a couple other things about Stand Fierce Punch I'm not remembering. I mean, I know you can do some stuff in V Trigger with it, if you wanna. Like, that kind of stuff. But I'll get to that when I talk about his V Trigger, I guess. Oh yeah, what's the damage compared to Crouch Fierce? 80 versus 90, that's what I thought. Crouch Fierce is a little bit stronger in situations where you're going for close Tatsu hits. Alright, let's talk about Crouch Hard Punch. This is also a crush counter because literally every hard normal Ken has is a crush counter. This one's pretty weird. It like throws the opponent into the air. You can juggle into a fireball. What can you actually? You can like cancel to a V skill and then you can juggle out of it like that. I don't know if that's the one they intended you to land. I think it is. I guess it is. I don't know if they really like had. I don't know what plans they had for this. That launch is really unusual. You can combo into a light fireball. And then from that light fireball, I think you can do. Was it like dash in hard ta EX Tatsu? And you can also do like dash in super as well. That's kind of hard. I missed my dash. I'm not very good with this combo, to be honest. It's like tight. But it does work, just take my word for it. There it is. I wouldn't say Guile has the best fireball in the game. I'd probably give that to, like, maybe Chun. I don't know. Guile does have the best fireball in the game if you're counting his V-skill fireball. In terms of outside that crush counter, that's not really the crush counter you want to pursue. It's more of an incidentally useful one, but it's not even that incidentally useful because, like, if you're going for incidental crush counters, you've got better crush counter normals and hard punch and hard kick. So Crouch Hard Punch is not super useful like that. And if you're going for a punish, then Hard Punch is your best one as well. So I don't really ever see people pursuing that particular crush counter, but it does exist, so I just wanted to show off a couple juggles that use it. More typically, oh yeah, I didn't even try this. I should give it a go because this is like how Ken gets the most damage out of a lot of his juggles. I'd like to get 3 hits, but 2 is still good. Fuck Ken. I think I'm getting some cross under issues because I'm getting a good motion there, but it's not giving me a Tatsu. There we go. That's probably your best conversion most of the time. Anyway, outside of crush counters, Crouch Hard Punch just does a little bit more damage than Stand Hard Punch. And in situations where you're trying to get a close Tatsu hit, that's really important. Check this out. Let's say I'm going for either Tark combo. If I go for Tark combos and go into Tatsu, well, I can get the first hit of Light Tatsu, but not the second. And I get the first and third, but not the second in medium Tatsu. If you get every hit of a Tatsu, like the first two of Light and the first all three of medium, it has a unique juggle state compared to the other, like getting parts of it. So it ends up doing a lot of damage, and you can still get follow-up combos. Here's a good example. This like. That will never work in a million years. But if I do crouch hard punch into light Tatsu, leads to hard uppercut. There are a few situations. It's more common in V trigger to do stuff like that because it leads to really good damage in V trigger. But just like, showing it off, it does actually work to do like combos like that. More typically, you'll see it into the medium Tatsu, and then you'll see it into the EX uppercut from there. That's like his go-to one bar. That does, I think, more damage. Hold on. I think more damage than anything you can get from a tower combo for one bar. That's his highest damage from Crouch Fierce. I think that's his highest damage from tower combo. So yeah, I added 40 damage by going for the medium Tatsu combo. So medium Tatsu leads to really nice damage when you can get all the hits, and you can get all the hits from a close normal, and that means no tower combos. So bypassing the tower combos is better if you want to use one bar. And also in V trigger, it's often better, but we'll talk about V trigger. But just as a like thing to be aware of, if you're going for like a if you have like a punish opportunity, Crouch Fierce into medium TP, I mean into medium Tatsu is really good. And then you can lead that to EX uppercut. I think he has a Tatsu to super combo somewhere, right? Or he used to. I don't know if he still does. That's it. It might be for medium as well. That might be optimal way of landing a super. Okay, it works for medium as well. I thought it might work with one and not the other, but both of them, medium is much preferred there then. So that's, I can't think of a super combo that would lead to as much damage as that. Like, I don't think anything from tower combo would lead to that much. I think the DP actually lowered my damage there. But I just can't see that being as strong. Yeah, nowhere close. So unless you're absolutely meterless, combos through Tatsu are better. And the only reason combos through Tatsu are worse is because you can't combo at all out of medium Tatsu unless you're investing some bar. That ends up doing quite a lot of damage, though. About time to finish this. I don't know if I've ever seen a Ken go for this combo, but most Kens don't really use super like this. Kind of the opportunities are rare. I see Kens go for medium Tatsu into EX uppercut all the time. EX is really good for Kens, so most Kens don't bother saving for their super. Ken has some of the best EX moves in the game. Let's see here. It's not all about Crouch Fierce, it's just his go-to cancel for like Tatsus, because it's the strongest of all his hard cancels. Stand Hard Kick. It's a pretty interesting move. It's a pretty good poke. It like goes further than most of his attacks. It's kind of similar to a Street Fighter 4 stand hard kick in both range and function. It does cancel the V skill, but not the special moves. And I don't think it cancels the super or anything. It cancels the V trigger as well. If you cancel it to V skill, I don't think you can do any of the things that he can do off of like stand hard punch, for example. So it's not as useful. You can use it to get in, but it's like on block, it's unsafe. So you really. On hit, you would rather go for a punish combo, and on block, you'd rather go for a you'd rather not V skill at all. It does the fact that it cancels the V skill is really useful though, because again, you can reaction V skill if you get a crush counter with this normal, and if you get a crush counter, you can then get like an uppercut from there. I usually use medium because in my experience, well, hold on, it's hard getting all three hits of hard here consistently, I think. There was some scenario where it was hard getting all hits. I'm trying it right now and it feels pretty easy. But I remember having poor success with hard versus medium here. Oh, you know what I think it was? I think it was like when I was playing this character a ton back in the beta. You could combo out of V trigger medium uppercut, so I would do medium uppercut and then I would like get combos like into super or something out of that EX uppercut. But I think those don't work anymore. Yeah, you used to be able to get a super there. I don't think you can anymore. That didn't work. Yeah, it looks like the recovery is like 10 times that. Talking about all the shit that was in the beta. I need to not even talk about that. That has nothing to do with the character as he exists now. Anyway, I think you can also combo into medium Tatsu, which is the best follow-up now, because you get all three hits pretty reliably. And if you get the medium Tatsu and you want to invest meter in an uppercut, it ends up doing quite a lot of damage. So poking with stand hard kick, pretty good little poke. And then if you ever see it be successful with V skill, you can just cancel into hard uppercut or medium Tatsu into EX uppercut. Medium Tatsu is kind of the best in general, I feel like, because it does damage that's not really that much worse and has good corner carry. And then you can easily decide whether you want to invest the extra bar. I feel like that's pretty good. Is there another thing about Stand Hard Kick? I know it can be used to start a lot of his like V-Trigger combos. Empty cancel into V-Trigger is pretty good with that normal. It has more range than Stand Hard Punch, which makes it really good for V-Trigger. So like if I'm just poking out with it, and I get a V-Trigger, then I can do something like that. I did Light Tatsu, but I should have done Medium Tatsu. But it like links into Hard Kick even at, like past max range. What is the combo there? I'm just doing that one, but I think there's something better you can do in V-Trigger, and I can't even get that one. Is it? God, what is it? Is it into an uppercut? Oh shit, that was hard uppercut. That didn't feel right. You can go into low strong from that. That might work in corners. My Ken is not super optimized, is it? Someone tell me what the go-to is after V-Trigger. I used to know. Well, it's in the bread and butter guide, I'm pretty sure. I just have to open that and look it up. I'm pretty sure I like tested pretty much every option he has and found the really good ones. So go consult that. I think it's a pretty good source. There, I think I did leave out Medium Tatsu into EX Uppercut almost entirely in the Ken bread and butter, and that's one of his like best combos. I think everything else is there, but that like one of his really fundamental combos, like for some reason I just missed it. That's all I gotta say about Stand Hard Kick. What about Crouch Hard Kick? This button is really long range and can be used to punish other sweeps. I always have the same exact things to say about every single sweep. It's almost like every single sweep is exactly the same. It goes really far, really fast, and doesn't care if the opponent's standing or crouching. If you happen to get a counter hit with it, it's a hard knockdown. Most of Ken's punishes for like a crouching opponent from really far away, if they're punishable. For example, if you block a sweep. If you block a sweep, the opponent's really far away, they're crouching, they're minus, they're punishable, but like most of the things you do won't necessarily hit. Ken's best options are, I think, hard uppercut or EX uppercut, or just a sweep of his own. Or like a super, something like that. Or like, if you have like meter, you can do like low strong into super. Probably be pretty good as a punish. But the point is, this is like a good like meterless answer to things like that. But it's almost never used, because you can do better stuff most of the time. It's too unsafe, and situations where it's guaranteed, better things are guaranteed. Command normals. He has a few. You got the towards hard kick. 23 frame overhead. That's pretty slow for people who don't know about how slow overheads are. Oh god. I just dropped my phone. All of 1 foot into my lap. Minus four on block, like most overheads in this game. It's slightly unsafe. Like a Chun-Li doing a reversal stand jab will punish you or something like that. But it is an overhead. It's probably Ken's worst overhead, because he's got two. It is situationally useful for the fact that it moves. You see this a lot at the very highest echelon of play. You see this from, like, Momochi and stuff. That little step, like, you can't, it's just, like, counter hit me, please, the attack. It looks really risky. It's just for how ridiculously slow this move is. You wouldn't want to do it in footsies. But a lot of people see that little step, and they're like, oh shit, it's the overhead, and they block high. And you can't just fake it. And the thing is, this causes a lot of people to, like, clam up. But only if they, like, respect you a lot. It's not something you can just do at the level of play. You're too liable to, like, run into an attack. But if the opponent's being really careful and waiting and watching, you might be able to sneak this in and then go for, like, a throw or something like that. The recovery is pretty long, though, so you have to have a good sense for when it ends. But you can catch people like that who are, like, shifting the high block when they see that Ken's going for the overhead. Or you could just go into like a poke or a normal or something like that. Use it to get a little bit of approach and free pressure going. It's really long to just do though. It's like, you know, you've got like, it's like 50 frames of animation. You're taking as long to approach them on the ground as you would if you were jumping in. So it's not that good. It's kind of gimmicky, but it does have a little bit of an itch. Back medium kick is his other overhead. This one's 21 frames, generously slowed down from other Street Fighters, I think. It's pretty quick. 21 frames is still reactable, and it is still minus. It's again minus 4. This one's a bit easier to space though because it has no actual approach to it, and there are situations you can do where you can get it meaty. I think after EX uppercut in the corner? I don't remember. There's like some scenario that's like pretty common for Ken where you can do back medium kick and it's like a true meaty. And then if you get it meaty like that, you can get it like. That might be it. It might be like one frame of waiting. Because that I actually got it too early. It's got three active frames, so it goes up to plus 2 on hit and up to minus 2 on block if you happen to get it on its last frame, which makes it far safer to attempt. So it's pretty good as a meaty attack. And yeah, it's got a kind of a tall hitbox, so it's good at catching people jumping. Like if they're trying to jump away on wake up, if they're doing like jump back throw attack, or if they're just like desperate to escape a corner or something like that. And I think it has a slam effect, right? I don't remember actually. I'm pretty sure it slams. Yeah, it's got a slam effect if you actually hit someone midair with it. It'll lock them over. That's all I gotta say about Mach medium kick. I don't think there's any human way to combo out of it unless you got last frame plus counter hit, it would go to plus 4, so then you'd be able to link a jab. That'd be really cool. I've never seen anyone do pull that off. Back medium punch is indeed minus 2 or neutral on block and on hit. So you surrender a little bit of pressure if you go into it on block. That normal, back strong. Neutral on hit, but you can combo it into stand fierce as a tart combo. And that tart combo, I've been doing. Ooh, I did it. A late cancel and it whiffed. That tart combo is really instrumental for his a lot of his damage. I haven't showed this off pretty much at all, but you can do juggles into like fireball or like uppercut, and then V trigger cancel him to get combos out of those, which you can't do with Tatsu. I don't know why I just tried to do what I just tried to do. But like for example that, you can get juggles with a V trigger that you can't get if you do Tatsu Enders. That's usually not super useful because they don't add that much damage compared to getting V trigger cancels on the ground like those. So the thing about back medium punch, you'll see this a lot, is that it's actually if you do back medium punch, back hard punch, the tart combo, it's minus 13 on block. So reaction punish pretty comfortably. Every character in the game can punish that. He's kind of close. It has almost no push out on block. They were very deliberate with that, I think. The opponent is like right next to you. You're minus 13. It's reactable. There's just like no saving that. Well, there is saving that. You can cancel to a fireball, but the fireball, you're still again. That gives you like a point blank fireball, and Ken's Hadoukens are minus 10. So even if a character doesn't have like the fa like most characters can hit Ken from this range within 10 frames. I'm not sure of a single character that definitely can't. Even like Zangief can like throw you. So you can't save yourself with an uppercut. You can't save yourself with a fireball, and you can't save yourself with a Tatsu. So you've really got to confirm that tart combo. But in the event that you do see yourself going for that tart combo, and you realize, oh shit, I just treated this like a confirm, and it wasn't a confirm, you still can save yourself with an EX fireball because EX fireball is plus 1. So EX Fireball, tart combo to EX Fireball is really notable because it is the only thing you can do that's safe from tart combo. And if you're one of those guys who like, is kind of learning Ken, still kind of new to the game, that is kind of a neat combo, if only because it carries very little risk. It requires bar, but it carries very little risk and it does good damage. And I think if you get an EX Fireball there, you can juggle into an EX Tatsu, right? There's like some weird combo from that. That might be corner only. Where it might not work at all, and I just made it up. Oh wait, there it is. That's a combo that you almost never see used. Two bars is really expensive, but just, it is the max damage conversion from EX Fireball if you're that guy who really likes to do EX Fireballs from the tart combo. I guess you could do EX Uppercut in the corner as well, if you want to, but I'm pretty sure. Oh, never mind. I'm pretty sure EX Tatsu out damages EX Uppercut, right? That was 150. 200. That's 160, 200. Yeah, EX Tatsu is the one you want to land if you can help it. I'm not even reading the chat. You guys can just fucking. I mean, I am reading the chat, but, like, I don't know what the fuck this bickering all is. I don't even understand what you guys are talking about. Meanpig Hard Kick is minus two on block if they actually stand block both hits, but the fact that they can crouch block it makes it really, really unsafe. But it's only minus two if they block, so if I implied that it was safe if they block it high, then I'm sorry. Or implied that it was unsafe, because it is safe. Minus two is safe. Let's see here. I guess I gotta talk about his. Oh, I never talked about his air special moves. Both his lights are kind of shitty for air-to-air reaction kind of attacks, but his uppercut can be auto-corrected fairly comfortably, so it's not super important that he has jump back anti-airs reliably. But both of them are kind of shitty. Jump short is probably the better one of the two. Jump medium kick is one of the best cross-ups in the game. It's got a nice big wide hitbox, so it's really comfortably easy to just be able to cross up with it. You can get, like, pretty much everything that Ken ever gets from it. It's, like, not hard to just go straight to Stand Fierce or, like, I don't know, back strong, whatever combos. All his regular ass combos work from after a cross up. Jump Fierce has a really nice angled down attack hitbox. So against some characters, if you, like, go for, like, that kind of meaty kind of jump where you're kind of next to them and you, like, jump as they take a throw or something like that, you can actually sometimes hit them before they recover. Like, that's how far down it goes. So, like, that's kind of gimmicky for a lot of characters, but Ken's got a sufficiently downward angled hitbox midair to actually, like, tag a couple characters. So it makes it kind of good for that kind of scenario. You can get some kind of baits, and if you get a really high jump hard punch, you can still usually convert into normal S stuff. Jump hard kick is pretty good too. I think it has the most lateral range of all his air attacks, so it's the one you want to go for if you're trying to get a really far jump over a fireball or something like that. I think Fierce and Roundhouse both do the same damage, so there's no sort of distinction from that. I'm not sure Jump Strong does anything. It might be good as like an air to air, I think. It might be one of his better air to airs, but you almost never see that. Ken's usually just use jump hard punch or jump hard kick or his cross up depending on the scenario. You don't really see the other ones at all. But that's how it is for every character. Let me take a sip of this green tea real fast. Okay, only I can say stop having opinions. Everyone else stop saying it. Special moves, I suppose. So Hadouken. I have so much to say about Hadouken, but it's not really specific to Ken. Ken's Hadouken is like Ryu's. It might be a little bit shittier. I wouldn't be surprised if it has an extra one or two startup frames and a little extra bit of recovery. But people like to drum up the differences between them a lot, but actually they're fucking damn close to the same move. Unlike most fireballs in this game, Ken and Ryu have a fireball that's, one, really fast. Ken's isn't quite as fast as Ryu's, but it's faster than most of the fireballs in the game, which is good and bad. The light one is still pretty slow. For both Ryu and Ken, so you still have the option of throwing a slow fireball. The hard fireball is faster than like Chun-Li's hard fireball or like Nash's light fireball or shit like that, I think. Which enables you to kind of hit people really early from ranges like this, like before they can churn out their reversals or their anti-fireball kind of things. Ken's is definitely worse in terms of speed. Like, it doesn't his light one isn't as slow as Ryu's, and his hard one isn't as fast as Ryu's. I think. So he doesn't quite have the versatility that Ryu has, plus like the extra recovery and whatnot. But he can still play fireball games, like in order to compete with s characters that aren't really good against fireballs. Like if you're fighting like a Mika, you can like zone her out with fireballs. People often think that because Ken's fireball is like a smidge worse than Ryu's, you basically can't throw fireballs. But he can like fall back on a fireball game really comfortably. Like in addition to all his like kind of good up close kind of like run and kind of pressure, he can fall back on a. He's very well rounded. He can fall back on a range game if he wants to. His EX fireball is pretty fast, right? Doesn't knock down. Ryu's does. Let's see here. The fact that it doesn't knock down is actually kind of nice because you can do like combos into EX Fireball and then like B trigger cancel them. I'm bad and I don't know how to play Street Fighter. There you go. Something like that leads to pretty good damage actually. I've got like a million things to say about ways you can use fireballs to control space. Like Ken, the strat does work for Ken of like throw enough fireballs to force them to jump and then uppercut their jumps. Ken has really solid anti-air, and Ken has really solid like ground control with fireballs. So if you're like if you want to play the classic Ryu style with Ken, you can fall back on it. Ken is slightly worse at it than Ryu is, but it still exists for him. He can still play that game of like control the ground, force the opponent to jump, then anti-air their jump. His reversals are not reversals. Well, reversals too, but his anti-airs are some of the better ones in the game. The fact that he has a meterless, true invincible anti-air is kind of a big deal in this game. What else about it? There's like one other thing I really wanted to mention about his fireball that was important. I can't remember what it was. Oh yeah, anti-air heavy Tatsu if they jump over a fireball. I can't even imagine that. I can't even imagine that. Holy fuck. Fuck Ryu's anti-air jab. God damn it, what was the thing about Ken's fireball? It was important. Oh yeah. Okay. So the thing about Ken and Ryu's fireball, unlike like say Chun-Li's or Nash's or Guile's, is that they get really wide. In Street Fighter 4, pretty much every character got enormously fucking wide every single time they threw a fireball. In Street Fighter 5, it's pretty much just Ryu and Ken. The only other fireball characters in this game stay pretty narrow. I think Laura, when she's charging her fireball, gets a little bit wide, but like not like super wide, not as wide as Ryu and Ken get. So if a character is fighting, even though they've got like kind of fast fireballs that force the opponents to react really early with their fireball answers, if you're fighting like a Mika doing Shooting Peach, EX Shooting Peach, or like a Laura doing maybe not EX Elbow, maybe like most characters doing super. Like if Ryu supered me from here, it would like actually go through my fireball and punish me, even from this far away, just purely because of how wide Ken gets. It makes fireball punishes work from further away. Like Chun-Li against Nash would have to super from like here in order to punish Nash's fireball, but against Ken she could do it from like here because of how wide Ken gets when he puts his hands out. It like straight up works from almost full screen. That's true for Ryu as well. So they've got kind of a unique fireball throwing animation that makes them more unsafe to compensate for the fact that their fireball has a little bit more speed versatility. I'm pretty sure I've said this a million times and everyone should know it at this point, but low fireballs in general are a bit stronger than, I mean, light fireballs, fuck, slow fireballs are stronger than fast fireballs in most instances in Street Fighter. I don't have that much to say about Hadouken besides that. 14 frame startup, combos from a lot of stuff. I think it doesn't combo from lights at all. Yeah. You gotta go into like a medium normal at some point if you want to combo a fireball. And I think from max range it doesn't combo from crouch medium kick. That was a hard fireball, so there you go. That was the earliest cancel on a hard fireball. Though strong, it's a bit more reliable. Pretty much the same deal with Ryu, but still not 100%. I think Ryu, even from the max range of his low strong, can still combo a hard fireball. Ken can't. Ken's fireballs are not quite as fast as Ryu's are. It's close, but not quite. You can use that as a confirm, though. I should have mentioned that. If you've got like super or something like that, you can do low strong into fireball and then react to a successful fireball with like a super. It's kick, isn't it? Hello? Maybe it's faster than I realized. That's something you can react with if you're like really on point looking for it. You can react to your successful low strong by canceling the fireball into super. But you got better super confirms than that. Especially if you can do crouch medium kick super, which theoretically works. Fucking Chun-Li style confirms. Third strike Chun-Li style confirms. Shoryuken? So Ken's light Shoryuken is 3 frames. The rest of them are 4. They're all crush counter punishable. They're really unsafe. You don't want to have these things blocked. They all do pretty good damage. 140, I think 130 for medium. Yeah. Hard goes pretty far and has really good juggle potential, which means it's useful for a lot of his combos. Which means it's useful for a lot of his combos. And then EX goes really far and has really good juggle potential, which means it's useful for a lot of his combos. You can get some like max range like punishes, like crouch medium kick to crouch medium punch into EX uppercut, stuff like that. I don't know. Far stand medium punch maybe? I don't know. More often use them for like punish combos and stuff like that. These are more versatile than his Tatsus are. His Tatsus are very stiff. Here you've got the ability to cancel hits into super or cancel hits into V trigger and then juggle from there, stuff like that. The main use of uppercut is the medium uppercut, which is his go-to anti-air. He can also anti-air with, I think, crouch hard punch, but it's not as good. You've got to do it kind of earlier, and it trades more. You'd prefer to use uppercut if you can help it, but if you're not too good on the uppercut motions on reaction, then you'd probably use crouch fierce. Just as a for the record, let's try it out just to see, just to get an idea of how consistent it is. Come at me, Ryu. I got a counter hit. It's good to be able to get a counter hit that high, but I want to win clean. If I could win clean, that would be a good proof of concept that this move is a decent anti-air. I'm doing it really early. You would do it this early in a match, but I'm going to try and do it late on purpose. Okay, there. He got the attack out. He actually became active. I didn't get a counter hit. That means the hard kick came out, and I still won without trading. But the thing about medium uppercut is that it works from a pretty good variance of ranges. Like, you can do it from really close. Or even, like, if they're going to jump over your head, you can autocorrect it pretty comfortably. And then it also works from really far away. Maybe this is like the farthest you can do it safely, because if they don't hit a button, you don't want to like uppercut their empty jump. But it like it's a pretty good range anti-air. So it's got a good range of effectiveness, and it actually has true invincibility. Like it's invincible until after it hits. It's got like 5 frames of invincibility or more. I don't know, at least five, because it won't even trade. So you can let the opponent like this is a really fast anti-air. If the opponent like. You can, I mean, safe jumps don't really exist in this game in the capacity they do because there are no like setups for them most of the time. But theoretically, 4 frames is good enough to like hit anything but an absolutely frame-perfect safe jump. You can do it faster, like you couldn't do a crouch hard punch on wake up, but you can do like a medium uppercut on wake up if they're going for like meaty jumps or stuff like that. If like Ryu knocks you over and goes for like a meaty cross up, you can wake up like this and it actually works instead of just losing. Yeah, it is taller than Ryu's medium DP, especially for the first hit. It's really easy with Ryu's medium DP to only get the second hit when you're anti-airing. But Ken, you can do it earlier and still get both hits. But you still want to do it as late as possible to maximize your invincibility. But like Ken, it's a little bit easier. Ken's got better uppercuts in general than Ryu does. But it does have true invincibility, and it does knock down, and it does do really good damage compared to most anti-airs. So, and it like works against even like dive kick style attacks. Like if like you need to churn it out really fast, the motion hurts a little bit. But like if you're fighting like a Chun-Li doing instant legs or a Cammy doing instant EX dive kick or a Ken doing instant EX Tatsu, medium uppercut still beats those, which is kind of a big deal. It'll work kind of regardless of the timing of the opponent's jump because it carries invincibility for a really long time. You can like anti-air like multiple different arcs. Like any character who can change their jump arc midair, like let's say like a Bison stomp into Devil's Reverse, or just like a Devil's Reverse by itself. It's like he could change his jump arc to like make your anti-air whiff for a lot of the cast, but Ken's medium uppercut will like beat the stomp and then also catch most Devil's Reverses. So like he doesn't really need to distinguish between changing jump arcs from characters who can change their jump arc. His one anti-air option will actually catch both of them most of the time. Just because of how tall it is and its invincibility. So that's like a really big strength Ken has, is the strength of his anti-airs. And I feel like I should mention, okay, invincible 1 through 6 for medium Shoryuken. I feel like I should mention that it's also like a good reversal on the ground. Again, 4 frames is really fast, so you can get it out in like no time. You can use it to easily interrupt windows between attacks. You can use it to easily wake up on, like, easily get up off the ground on wake up if the opponent's going for meaties. Only four characters in this whole game have a meterless invincible reversal. It's like Nekali, Kami, and both Shotos. So if you play one of those characters, it's kind of a big deal that you always have that available and the opponent always has to bait it. Or not always has to bait it, but like they always have to have it in their mind. It's part of the core mix-up all the time to occasionally bait uppercuts, which means anytime the opponent tries to bait an uppercut and you don't go for one, you wake up safely, which is kind of a big deal. Kind of a big deal that Ken has this option to just like threaten them with, even if he doesn't use it, it's still helping him. That being said, if you actually have an uppercut blocked, it's your ass on a silver platter. There's a lot to say about the other uppercuts, but I feel like I'm just going to talk about them when I'm talking about his combos. So I don't really want to say that much. I only wanted to talk about Shoryuken and footsies, which is pretty much anti-air medium uppercut or wake up medium uppercut, because the other ones don't have as much invincibility. EX has quite a lot of invincibility. You can use EX if you don't if you want more damage and more reward than medium, but like medium is usually better because the damage increase isn't that significant. The range increase is kind of nice if they try and shimmy or Shoryuken or something. I don't know. Fuck. I feel like I should mention this right now. Medium uppercut can be canceled to V trigger, but it's unsafe. I don't know the exact minus frames. I've heard minus 5, but I think it's worse than that. But I don't know the exact window. But if you're trying to like do a reversal and then make it safe, you're shit out of luck. That just gives the opponent more time to react and go for their punish. You can use like a fucking wake up option. Or you can, and it works, and when it works, you can combo them on reaction. But the problem is that if they block it, you're not any more safe than if. I mean, you are a bit more safe. Actually, that's I should talk about that. That's important. A crush counter punish on this medium uppercut sucks, and you take a lot of damage. If they cancel your V-trigger canceled one, they don't get a crush counter punish, so that can be better for you. You can use your V-trigger to minimize the punish you're taking, I guess. I don't think most people would use it like that. V trigger is more useful elsewhere. Sure, you can anti-airs, reversals, combos, in a nutshell. Last I heard, I'll show you use V trigger cancel on all hits R minus 5. Thank you. Let's see here. Tatsumaki. So, you got three Tatsus. They're literally like combo enders. I don't think you'd use them for anything other than combo ending. Light Tatsu is the fastest, and combos into Hard Tatsu on close connect on grounded opponents, and it also goes really far. Rathmatic's here in the chat to correct my Ken fucking thing. V Trigger Shoryu used a bunch. Enlighten us, Rathmatic's. Anyway, Light Tatsu is really fast and. It's the only one that combos after like lights, and more importantly, it's 3-frame startup, so you can use it in a lot of scenarios. Hey, you skipped over V trigger uppercut, switch the sizes in the corner. This is my video, dude. Go away. That is the real Rathmatics. I wouldn't be. I don't know why I would. Why I don't know who's out to impersonate him. V trigger uppercut. Oh, you mean like V trigger uppercut? No, I haven't even talked about V trigger yet, dude. Fuck, hold on. I'll talk about V trigger like at the end when I actually talk about, like, you know, V trigger. It changes everything. Chill out. Chill out about this video. All the Tatsus are unsafe on block. Chill, fuck. I don't fucking. I'm ignoring the chat a sec. Tatsu. Where were we? Light Tatsu is super, super quick. Man, I'll talk about fucking cancels into V trigger when I talk about V trigger. Fuck, shut up. It's not even that good. It is that good, but like, fuck, hold on. Light Tatsu, really fast, okay? 3-frame startup, kind of a big deal. Lets you combo out of Stand Fierce on reaction. On reaction's a bit strong. It's minus 8 on block if they happen to block it. I think it's worse than that if they crouch because it whiffs its later hits. Medium Tatsu. I'm literally so distracted right now from the fucking everything that's going on in the chat. They're just combo enders. Fuck. Mathematics, go out of here. Go home. Let me just start from the top. Let me just reset everything. All of his Tatsu. I've showed off pretty much every single situation where you would use a Tatsu in the situations where I've been showing off Tatsus. Light Tatsu is useful after light normals. It's useful after situations where you want to get like a hard uppercut. It's useful in situations where you need to combo a 3-frame attack. That is pretty much the extent of its usefulness that I'm aware of. Medium Tatsu does a lot more damage. It's actually like the start of his strongest combos for one bar. And it's the start of a lot of his strongest combos anyway, and his strongest combos was super. But it's only really stronger if you're getting. Oh, I didn't mention this about medium Tatsu at any point previously when I was showing up medium Tatsu combos, but it is the max damage juggle a lot of the time. But the scenarios in which you get all the hits of medium Tatsu are kind of difficult to get.
Oh god, I'll show that off later. You can get all three hits there, for example. It's kind of precise to time, though. It's like harder than it looks. Even if you don't get all three hits, I think you can generally combo with a EX Uppercut, but getting all three hits is naturally preferred. I like made a video where I showed this off. It's not that precise. It's not so precise that you can't do it, but you do need to have a pretty good sense on the timing. Oh god, I missed my dash. I'm gonna give it a few more tries, but you'll just have to take my word for it if I can't get it now. You can do dash in. It might require a low connect here, or else you need a just an uppercut like that. If you get the first hit and then the last hit connects as a cross up, you can actually combo an uppercut, like a hard uppercut. There it is. You can get that. That's theoretically your max damage conversion. It's not so hard that you can only get it once in 100 tries. I'm just bad. Okay, if you practice that with Ken, you'll get it reliably. It's not as hard. It's not so hard that it's impractical. But in most situations where you can cause a juggle state, Medium Tatsu can get all of its hits. And then you can, from there, get EX Uppercut. So it's like the best, it's the best thing he can juggle into outside of B-Trigger. Which is kind of important. Missed a hit. I think I did this earlier when I was trying this out. There it is. Good for juggles. Hard Tatsu is pretty interesting. It's really slow starting up. It's 16 frames as opposed to 3 frame light Tatsu and 6 frame medium Tatsu. So you can't really just use it willy-nilly in the wild. It does do the most damage of all its Tatsus, and it does, like, you know, if you have absolutely no other conversions from out of light Tatsu or out of medium Tatsu available, if you have no meters, anything like that, hard Tatsu does the most damage of any of your enders. It's also safe on block. It's the only one that's safe on block. If you get the final hit to connect, it's minus two. That being said, it is asking for a lot of trouble to just, like, hard Tatsu in, like, hoping that they block, hoping that they don't eat hits. It's they can anti-air that on reaction in the same way that they would anti-air jump on reaction, so it's not that good. And even then, minus two isn't great. Like, minus two, you can still get punished. That being said, I feel like that goes through fireballs, doesn't it? Not that you would ever use it like this, but I'm pretty sure it does. It's for the fireball. I mean, I guess that went through fireballs, technically speaking. You would, yeah, this is like this is really impractical. But this is a proof of concept. And I didn't even punish, honestly. Don't use this to go through fireballs, dude. It's bad. No one do that. I'm sorry I brought it up. Hard Tatsu is normally just a combo ender. It's minus 56 on... Oh, shit, no, that's EX. EX is minus 56 on block. Be really careful about EX. Okay, EX talks to... I haven't talked about it at all, pretty much. It juggles pretty much every scenario where you can juggle anything, except, I think, medium Tatsu into EX DP. Yeah. Every other juggle scenario he has, you can just go into EX Tatsu, and technically EX Tatsu is the highest damage available. So, like, for example, like if you get like a juggle into hard uppercut, and we trigger cancel that, you can go into EX Tatsu from there. That one's kind of... I picked a hard one to do. But, like, it's your max damage combo under. I think it does more than EX uppercut. Yeah, I showed that off. What else about EX Tatsu? It combos really fast. It's much faster than hard Tatsu. So, like, in a scenario where you do crouch medium kick, like, let's say if you were doing hard Tatsu, that would never combo. But if you're doing EX Tatsu, it would. And I think it works on crouching opponents, unlike other Tatsus. I think that's true. Yeah, so in scenarios where you're doing, like, empty cancels and whatnot, if you do an empty cancel into, like, a... Oh, shit, the Olive Ken's hit. Aw, damn it. Motherfucker. Olive Ken's Tatsus hit crouching opponents. Except that one. Except the last hit of that one. There you go. Proof of concept, even hard Tatsu hit crouching opponents. Alright, that's the distinction that Ken doesn't need to make, then. But still, EX Tatsu has much better rewards and empty cancels than his other Tatsus do, and it also goes further. Try MK Tart combo, hard Shoryuken, cancel halfway with V-Trigger, then do a delayed hard Shoryuken. I didn't expect that to land on that side. I don't know why I did that. Oh god, this is tricky. It's gonna gobble up my motion so hard. I might need to do a special motion, or I could just autocorrect it. That's gonna be really weird though. I did the wrong direction if I wanted an autocorrect. I just backed up a little bit, made it easier. There you go, I did that combo. Were you wondering if it worked, or you want me to show it off? Because there it is. If you're going to add a V-trigger to a combo, you want to do it while the opponent's still grounded, if you can help it. Like, you can do, like, mid-combo V-triggers to increase damage, like, even after you've launched. Like, that does a pretty good damage, 251. But if you're doing that, it does more. So you can increase your damage with, like V-trigger. But if you increase your damage with V-trigger, if you use V-trigger before you knock them over, it increases your damage by a lot more. I don't know why I did that combo of all combos. Fuck, that's not an uppercut. If you can help it, you'd rather have, like, grounded V-trigger. But oftentimes you can't help it, can you? Oftentimes you just get one scenario and you need to pop that V-trigger. Fuck, I don't want to talk about Tatsu anymore. What about Air Tatsu? So the thing about Air Tatsu is that it changes his jump arc just a little bit, and it can cross up, but the range where you can get cross-up Tatsu versus a non-cross-up attack is so fucking precise in this game. You have to be, like, a very specific distance away. But that mix-up still works. Like, jump-in attack versus same distance, jump-in, cross-up Tatsu. It's just really, really precise. That was, like, right about where it works. That being said, you need a very low cross-up to actually be able to combo out of it, which makes it really impractical to get this kind of mix-up going, because it's basically a non-mix-up. They can block, like, Ryu could block to the right early and then to the left late, and, like, be able to block both options, for example, just because of how incredibly late you need to be able to do it. If you actually get that cross-up Tatsu, it does lead to, like, a back medium punch or a jab or something like that, if you're really, really precise. More typically, in V-Trigger, it, like, has longer hit stun, so you can, like, link stuff more easily. It's, like, kind of comfortably. You can kind of comfortably link after V-Trigger. Like, that one I hit pretty high. I pretty much haven't seen Ken's pull that out at all. Like, I never see Ken's go for, like, cross-up a regular Tatsu in V-Trigger, even though it's theoretically kind of good. It is kind of off of a jump-in, and jump-ins... You don't get that many opportunities for jump-ins in this game, so it's, like, not nearly as useful as it was in Street Fighter 4, where you could, like, get a hard knockdown and then go for a jump that crossed up, and a jump that didn't cross up, or a cross-up Tatsu that made their reversal whiff, or, like, shit like that. You don't have meaties, which means that this setup is not as practical as it used to be. But you can combo it more easily on V-Trigger. That's one of the really big differences V-Trigger makes for Ken. Let's see here. Air EX Tatsu is kind of the main one. It's not really useful to do a really low Tatsu for Ken. It just kind of gives him this awkward hitbox that, like, has a hard time hitting anything. But his Air EX Tatsu has a downward angle to it that functions pretty much like a dive kick. Like, pretty much fully like a dive kick. Functionally, this is almost no different from Kami's dive kick, Kami's EX dive kick. He can do it, like, as low to the ground, it hits as quickly. The thing about this that makes it really good is that it fucks with a lot of characters' anti-airs. Like, let's say you have a character like Bison, who wants to do, like, a crouch hard punch on reaction to a jump. If he, like, is just watching and waiting for you to jump and then, like, hits crouch hard punch when you would be over his head, this will counter hit that crouch hard punch. So this will just hit him, like, as soon as he hits the button, but before his attack can become active. It's really good at getting in way faster than, like, characters are expecting. It's got a completely different timing than a normal jump-in. It's also safe on block and launches on hit, and that launch leads to, like, good damage. I've been doing jab resets. A lot of people do, like, stand medium kick resets into V-Trigger or V-Skill or stuff like that, or just stand medium kick into, like, you know, dash in or anything. If you want to, you can do, like, a juggle into, like, EX Tatsu or Hard Uppercut. Hard Uppercut's a lot more common because the damage loss is not very significant. You might as well not burn the bar. And again, I showed off you can do juggle into like medium Tatsu. And if you really want to get into the specifics, you can do juggles into more Air EX Tatsus. I'm not very good at these. But if you get kind of like a low hit like that one, whoa. Fuck my emotions. That looked good. Why'd it fuck up? That one looked good too. I must be attacking before the height restriction. I did that just out of desperation. Or not out of desperation, but like I was surprised that I got it, so I just did something random. Anyway, the point is you can get multiple Tatsus if you get a low connect like that. The low connects are kind of better because they're more frame advantage on block. You want to hit their legs, not their head. But it's basically like a dive kick. You can use this to like arc over fireballs kind of safely. You can use it to kind of safely jump. It does cost meter though, but it's basically a mix-up with his normal jump. You can block to get out of both, but if you're just blocking jump-ins, then Ken's going to pretty much be getting in like all the time. Hard Tatsu after the Air EX Tatsu for 1 meter corner carry. Does that really work? God, I feel like I should have known about that. Really early. I'm guessing you have to do it on a low connect too. But I'll try it on a high connect just to see. Yeah, it doesn't look good after a high connect. No, I still got it. Anyway, that Air EX Tatsu is arguably one of the most broken things Ken has because it lets him pretty much have a dive kick in a game that has almost no dive kicks. It's like him and Cammy. Maybe like another one I'm forgetting. I guess Nikali technically has a dive kick. I don't have that much to say about Air EX Tatsu beyond this. I like Ken's V trigger is really complex. I'm gonna do my best to give it like a quick once over. Let's talk about his V skill first. It's a run. If you just cancel moves into it, it's pretty unsafe. Like, I don't think he has a single way to cancel into run on block that can't be punished. Like, every single character in the game can at least do reversal jabs and then hit confirm a combo. So you really don't want to just be doing it willy-nilly, but if the opponent does, like, if the opponent is in kind of like a kind of turtle mode, you maybe can sneak it in and go for, like, a throw reset or something like that. I've had, like, decent success with that, but now that Ken's existed for a while, I think people will be better at punishing these, because these are pretty much all unsafe. On hit, everything's safe. Well, not everything, but like on hit, like Stand Fierce into run will be safe. That's suddenly like no, that's still not safe, is it? That's plus 5 on hit, and it goes to minus 3. Yeah. No, it's not plus 5 on hit. Wait, hold on, I'm freaking out. I think that's minus 5. God, it would be hard to test. Whatever. Cancels into run are kind of risky. Okay, that's all you need to know. And he's got, if you hold the run button, he's got a little hit that he can do, the V skill. This is notable because it does build V meter, and it's like the only way. Same Fierce into run is plus 3 on hit. Yeah, I know it's plus on 3 on hit. I was trying to think of what it is on. Okay, yeah, okay, it's plus 3 on hit. That is what I was trying to think of. I'm just dumb. I got confused because I was thinking about on block. Plus 3 on hit because you can combo into light Tatsu and stuff. That also means it's like, you know, if you don't do anything, then you get like a little bit of pressure, but you would just combo if you could help it. Anyway, fuck. Where was I? V skill hit. It is the only way he can build V meter, I'm pretty sure. And I'm pretty sure you can juggle into it from a few things. Not that you ever see them. That might work. Maybe not. That works anyway. Anyway, it's like the only way he actually has to build V meter, besides taking damage or blocking. But it's so impractical to actually land in a real match, so I never see anyone do it. I like don't know what it's for because it's kind of unsafe on block. I'm pretty sure it's hard to use it like a step kick in Street Fighter 4. It's minus 6, and it knocks down on hit. One kind of neat thing that a lot of people don't know about it is that it's you can cancel it to V trigger if you want to, which lets you get nice combos out of it. Let's see here. I guess I don't have that much to say about V-Skill besides what I've already shown off. V-Trigger. What actually does it do? It changes the property of all his special moves. I don't think it changes the damage on any of his normals or anything like that, but I could be 100% wrong on that. Looks the same to me. Basically, his shurikens have less recovery. So, like, his light DP has, like, almost no recovery, which means you can get some juggles out of it that you wouldn't normally be able to get. It doesn't really make them safe or anything like that, so don't go crazy, like, oh my god, my reversal uppercut is, like, way better now that I'm in B-trigger, I won't be punishable. But his DPs do lose recovery, so you can do stuff that you can't normally do, like that. Light DP into EX DP normally doesn't work, but it doesn't B-trigger because light DP recovers faster. There's a couple other instances of that. I don't know, a lot of the ones that I used to use are kind of gone from the game. But it is good for that. His fireballs, I think, do they knock down? Yeah, they knock down. Kind of like reuse B-trigger in that regard. Can't charge them or anything. No guard break. But they do knock down. It's kind of useful. Kind of incidentally useful. I mean, it's not bad. It's better to have a fireball that knocks down than a fireball that doesn't knock down. In most instances. And I think they knock down in such a way that if you cancel the super, it does juggle. Like, they actually launch. His fireballs launch. Am I bad? Let me just... Okay. Yeah. So, not like a slam or anything. Still very combo accessible. And then his Tatsus have, like, like a different juggle state, I think. They go further. I think that doesn't combo it. It doesn't combo to the startup hit at max range. Or, like, I got the startup hit from further than you normally do. Let me think. Like, he still has combos out of Tatsu. Like, the combo into hard uppercut gets a bunch of extra hits compared to what it does normally. I ran out of V-trigger, like, right then. He's got increased juggle potential on his uppercuts in V-trigger as well. V-trigger EX fireball in the corner leads to mad damage. That's true. I thought that was the combo. Is it EX uppercut? That is mad damage. During V-trigger, light kick and medium kick Tatsu can cancel out fireballs. I have never seen a single person do that, and I did not know that was possible. God, I'm so reliant on, like, what I see Kens do. That's kind of neat. It's gonna be hard to actually use that in a match, but it's kind of neat. You can just use your own fireballs to cancel out fireballs. It is notable that Ken's V-trigger doesn't, it doesn't get used up by any of his special moves or anything like that. It's not like birdies or anything. Bison. Those characters. Let me take another sip. My throat's super hurting. Yeah, that's a combo. I was going to show that off and I forgot about it. The Tatsus launch a little bit higher, so some new juggles are available. But, like, the main juggles you want to go for, like, I think this into hard uppercut works, right? Medium Tatsu, hard uppercut, and V-trigger. Pretty sure that works. Doing it late. Ugh, it might be corner only. I'm, like, 80% sure that's a combo. God, I don't know the timing on this recovery. Alright. I guess it was the 20% because it looked like I got it there and that wasn't it. I guess still EX only. What a bust. Oh well. Light Tatsu into hard uppercut does a lot of damage in V-trigger if you want to use that. That's like a really high damage meterless combo that suddenly becomes available. Like, compare... that at 265. Versus that, 299. Just to give an idea of, like his meterless damage changes a lot. Oh, that HK Tatsu stuff that turned out bad before works super good in V-trigger. What are you talking about? You talking about, like, over fireballs? Does that work? Is that better now? Oh, wow, it is better now. That got earlier hits. I guess it's lower to the ground. Or something. Ken is a little bit like Shades of Akuma. Oh shit, I've still got jumping on. It said one there. Yeah, that's actually decent now. Very interesting. I mean, I don't know if it's decent. I don't know if you could do it on reaction to a fireball that comfortably. It's safe on block. And if you did it on reaction, like you don't need to do it on reaction to a fireball, but they could just anti-air you, so it's not that good. Way better hitbox than trigger. All right, very useful. Oh, and I didn't show this off, but like Mathematics was talking about it, and I should show it off if only like you know, because it is true. If you're cornered and you're doing that prayer medium uppercut V trigger, it gets you out of the corner. Not only does it get you out of the corner. Let me set some settings really fast. Not only does it get you out of the corner, God damn it, Ryu, get closer. But you can actually juggle out of it to pretty good damage. I'm pretty sure that works. It might be light into EX. I thought it was light into hard, though. Am I wrong? Oh, there it is. Light into hard. You just gotta do both of them, like, instantly. But that gets you out of the corner, gets the opponent into the corner, and it's still really unsafe, but it's like it's safer than doing a raw reversal. But that being said, it gives the opponent like, you know, it gives the opponent plenty of time to think about their absolute max damage punish because there is that V trigger freeze. That being said, a lot of characters can't do their max damage punish off of like a -5 attack. Like if I'm Birdie, I could punish like a Ken uppercut with like stand hard kick into like, you know, something like that. Crouch Fierce. That's gonna do a fuck ton of damage. But if Ken like V trigger cancels, all of a sudden I'm fucking punishing it with like stand short into Light Bullhead. So it's not you can save yourself from some punishes, and also it's much better on hit, for example. So that's like something that you should be aware of if you're like a Ken player, that you can't just like save yourself like that. And it's like a really good scenario it creates for Ken. There's a lot to say about V Trigger. I definitely haven't touched everything, but like there's so much it changes. I said that it gave air Tatsus more. Oh, this is really important. Hold on, time out. I can't believe I didn't mention this. This is arguably the most important thing. Air EX Tatsu and V Trigger does not knock down. So it's plus a lot, and you can go straight into your really high damage combos. Like you can actually link into like your grounded max damage kind of bullshit. Depending on how many hits you get, it might be easier or harder. But like that did so much damage. 315 for like an Air EX Tatsu. Compared to if I'm out of V trigger, it does like that was not my max damage, but it's close. There you go. 26. I'm getting an extra 100 damage. And like not only an extra 100 damage, but a higher capacity to get damage because I can add like meter more easily. Like let's say I get like a no, DP into trigger is not counter hit punishable. That's one of the reasons it's like safer. What am I gonna do here? Oh shit. I mean, that wouldn't actually be that bad. That's not what I wanted. I think it's pretty clear that, like, you know. I guess Stand Fierce would be more reliable here because it's wider than Crouch Fierce. Fuck. That would have actually done it. Let me try Stand Fierce. This window is really strange. The opponent's in recoil for a long fucking time, but I'm in recoil for a long fucking time. Oh, I can't get it. I'll just go straight into medium Tatsu and then go into EX Uppercut from there. That's just an example combo. There's better stuff you can go for. But that just shows off the damage potential of Air EX Tatsu. It's pretty high. It depends on what you mean by an FADC. Unsafe move that you can cancel. I'm pretty sure. Well, Birdie can do the same thing with his EX Bullhorn, but that's quite punishable on reaction as well. I should talk about a super. I didn't talk about it that much. I mean, well, I should talk about it. I think if you go into it from no special move cancel, if you do like a both his start combos launch, and if you cancel into like hard uppercut, I think you can cancel the second hit of hard uppercut. But I think it won't combo into super, right? Yeah. So you have to cancel the first hit, and if I think if you're canceling the first hit, medium uppercut is better. So I think the combo is like that might be it, or it might be the first hit of hard. Yeah, it's the first hit of hard. That's the only way to go about it. I'll try light just to make sure. Yeah. Yeah, so the combo you would do there, which would be preferred, is fireball, which I just dropped. No, that's a very third strike feely combo. It's like the same exact inputs, I just realized that. Back strong, fierce, fireball, super. And the super's down forward kick. That felt good. Yeah, if you're in V trigger, you can cancel the second hit. More hits of DP, I think, are cancelable to super. That still didn't work. It might be medium DP. Man, I don't remember. Nah, medium DP only has one. God, fuck. Try light. That didn't work either. It might be. I think he. He could do that at one point. Doesn't seem to work now. Man, I don't remember Ken's combos. Just read the fucking B&B. I made the B&B for a reason. Go consult it. Ken's super also goes through fireballs, which literally no one does, but it's available. So if you want to do it, then, you know, do it. It, like, it's wider than people give it credit for. You can do it in reaction to a fireball pretty comfortably. It's not, it doesn't go this far against most characters. Ryu's just wide. But, like, it's like round about here. It's the max range. Oh. So, like, half screen, you can punish fireballs in reaction. If you're fighting, like, a Chun-Li, it'll be, like, here, I think. Which is still reactable because her fireball's a bit slower. I've never seen anyone go through a fireball with Ken Super, I don't think. But it is possible, and it is important to share because it theoretically is kind of practical. But again, Air EX Tatsu is one of the best EX moves in the game. Air EX, I mean, grounded. Yeah. EX DP adds a ton of damage to a lot of his combos. So if you can, like, land those combos into EX DP, it's worth the bar. EX Fireball makes a star combo safe. That one's less useful. But, like, Ken has, like, one of the best slews of EX attacks in the game. So most people just use those. I, like, back in the Street Fighter 4 ones, I ended with, like, bread and butters that you should be aware of. But I don't even want to do that anymore, especially not with Ken, where I, like, clearly don't have them, like, on the top of my head. Just purely because I have an entire video of the bread and butters, and you should just go watch that instead. So I guess I'm done with Ken. I don't know. I've, like, talked about everything he has. There's more about V-Trigger that I didn't talk about, but just, like, go and watch a Ken player. Go watch Momochi, and you'll see everything. We should, like, end with, like, good players to watch. I've, like, thought about that a lot, but the problem is that kind of list changes so much over time. I remember, like, I did stuff like that for a couple of the how to play so-and-so characters, and then, like, people, like, changed them. Like, there was, like, 2 minutes when, no, I don't remember. People are finicky about their mains of in an evolving game. Especially a game like this where most of the characters don't exist yet. Oh yeah, I should mention that. That's worth mentioning. Ken's V reversal is super, super quick, but also it doesn't knock down and only does 40 damage instead of 60, which kind of sucks. It does have good surprise value, I guess, but I would call it, like, one of the worst V reversals in the game, to be 100% honest. But it is really fast, which means that it's basically guaranteed to work compared to other V reversals, which can be more easily blocked on reaction. But I just wanted to show that off. Ken's V reversals, one of three V reversals in the game, along with Chun-Li and Zangief, that does not knock down. Not counting ones that don't hit at all. The evasive ones, like Fung and Rashid and whatnot. Someone said zero on block, is that true? It's minus two on block, I thought. Is it only zero? If it's zero on block, that's kind of cool. I didn't know that. Kind of interesting. Kind of an interesting V reversal. Doesn't, like, work like most V reversals. Yeah, I said Momochi plays Ken. I'm just saying, like, you know, Momochi's the only character I can say long term will probably play Ken for, like, a long part of the game's life. And even then, like, Momochi's changed characters a bunch of times. I said in, like, the Cody, like, how to play Cody, I said, like players to watch, and I listed Momochi. And Momochi, like, stopped playing Cody, like, right around then. I'm, like, nervous about recommending Momochi as a player to watch, because he's changed mains quite a lot over the course of, like, Street Fighter. I've seen him play Yan and Makoto in Street Fighter 3. I've seen him play, I think, another character still, but I don't remember who. I've seen him play Cody and I think Jury, right? Was it Jury? I don't remember. And like Ken, and there was like one other character. He's played like several characters in Street Fighter 4 as well.